So welcome to the Institute Dr. Milosevic in Herzegovina. It has nothing to do with Mr. Milosevic. It is, or whatever, with the one Slobodan. It's a health center here. It was the prime site of Yugoslavian seaside tourism. Here you see, I'm here at the garden of the facility. This is basically the compound. That's the beach access. You know, I'm not sure they have privatized it now. I know that they tried it. There was never the right investor. And now we are in 2021, and this huge prime facility, this is a huge compound here. Seaside, beautiful. And here, this ancient facility, which are all over Yugoslavia. There are similar things happening. Most of them are privatized, the ski centers and the places. And this is really huge. I see here the beach, most beautiful location. Yugoslavia knew about property locations. Here, the back of the mountains. And here you see this place. And I call it huge. Yeah? And there is this building. And there's one more that over there belongs also to that. That's two buildings, yeah. That's the, whatever, the apartment blocks over there, just to show you. Here it's a very big building. And here, this is the hospital also with tourism facilities. And it's a kind of a resort spa center. And it was meant, and it is very nice. And my question now is, why it's not privatized? Is there nobody in the world with money for such a thing? It's expensive. Privatization, then reconstruction, redevelopment. You need probably €1 billion. Yeah, something like that. Maybe €500 million. Yeah, maybe less. I mean, all in all, I don't know. Yeah, it's expensive, you know, it's nobody with small change problems. But you know, where in the world you can get such a facility with this kind of beach access here, I mean, mountains, and you have even December. You have in December this kind of climate. Of course, you need, you have also rain in December, and you need also facilities for indoors. You need a lot of facilities because it can be very rainy, but it's never snowing. It's most of the year very nice. And you have all this beautiful Dubrovnik and Kotor just around the corner, all the nautical possibilities. I mean, if this is not a location for year-long tourism, and you have actually educated health workforce here and the infrastructure for health tourism, which is second to none. So it's all possible. It just needs the right investor. And European Union membership would extremely help this process to build consumer and investors' confidence. The Euro and NATO have already helped. That's over there, my hotel. So it's possible to do good things here. And not my hotel, the hotel I stay here. Just don't get the wrong impression. I'm just a humble podcaster here. I'm just saying, inside the EU, many things will be possible. Outside, it's pretty lonely. And more to come from Pax Europiana. And wherever you are, support Montenegro's EU accession. It's now time to get inside. Thanks a lot. All the best. Bye.